Hello to all students. Today we are starting with the structure of the human sperm. This is the structure of the human sperm, where you can see that there are four parts: the head, neck, middle piece and the tail. Okay, so how many parts are there? Total there are four parts: head, neck, middle piece and tail. Okay. Now, if I talk about the human sperm, then human sperm is motile, right? Because it is motile because of the presence of the tail, right? And the human sperm was first of all discovered by a scientist known as the Leeuwenhoek. And the viability period of sperm after it is released in female genital tract is 24 to 48 hours. It is in between 28 to 48 hours, because after this it will become non-viable. Means after this time period, it will not able to fertilize the ovum. Okay, and the rate of movement per minute. What is the rate of movement per minute of sperm? So it is 1.5 to 3 mm. It is 1.5 to 3 mm per minute. Okay, now if I talk about the structure of the human sperm, then the very first thing what I have to discuss here is the head. It is the most important part of the sperm, and in head I have to discuss two points. One is known as the nucleus, okay, and the another one is known as the acrosome, right? I have to discuss the nucleus as well as I have to discuss the acrosome. Now, very first, the nucleus of a sperm. The nucleus of a sperm is a elongated one. The nucleus is elongated and it is haploid. Means it is having one set of chromosome. As you know very well that a sperm is a gamete, and gametes are always haploid cell. So definitely the nucleus is haploid. Means it is N, having one set of chromosome, and this nucleus is having, or it is containing the chromosomal. It is containing the chromosomal material. Chromosomal material is mainly the, it is mainly the DNA, though a small quantity of protein is also found. But remember this thing, that nucleus is elongated, it is haploid, and the chromosomal material is found, okay, and in this chromosomal material mainly the DNA is present, although some amount of the, we can say it as protein is also found. And remember this thing, that head consists of a very little amount of cytoplasm. Why? Because nucleus is very much well developed. Okay. Now, if I talk about the acrosome, the second part, acrosome. So, acrosome is a cap-like structure. It is a cap-like structure present above the nucleus. And how this acrosome originates? So remember this thing, that the origin of the acrosome is by Golgi body of spermatid. You all know that precursor of sperm is spermatid. Means the sperm is formed by the spermatid. So what I want to say, students, that the spermatid, the Golgi body of the spermatid basically forms the acrosome. Now, the real question is that what is the role of the acrosome in the sperm? So, remember this thing that acrosome release certain enzymes which are also called as sperm lysins, these are proteolytic enzymes. Okay, so what is the role? The role of the acrosome is to release the sperm lysins. I am quoting here few examples of sperm lysins. Might you have been heard? Hyalo, uro, nidase, hyalo, uro, nidase, and the second one is the acrosin. These are the sperm lysins or the proteolytic enzymes released by the acrosome. And what they will do? They break the egg membranes. They break the egg membranes for fertilization. As you know very well, students, that the egg is surrounded by egg membranes. Okay. If you have heard about Jonah pellucida, okay, corona radiata and all. So remember this thing that if the sperm wants to enter into the egg, the problem is that egg is surrounded by the egg membranes. There is a barrier of the egg membrane. So the acrosome, which is present at the tip of sperm, releases these sperm lysins. Say for the most important one is the hyalouronidase, which will break the egg membrane and due to which the sperm will enter into the egg, and ultimately the sperm and the ovum will fuse together and the act of the fertilization will happen. Okay, so this is about the head region. That head consists of a elongated nucleus as well as the acrosome. One thing more I want to tell you here, that the whole of the sperm is surrounded by plasma membrane, right? You must see here that the whole of the sperm, the complete entire sperm, is actually surrounded by the plasma membrane. Okay, now coming to the second point, that is known as the neck. Now you can see here that neck is present between the middle piece, and the head. And it is not explained in your NCERT, so you must know about the neck region. So see here, neck, this is the second part of the sperm, right? It is present between head and middle piece. And in the neck region, remember this thing, that an angle of 90 degrees, two centrioles are formed. One is known as the proximal centriole, and another is known as the distal centriole. Both these centrioles are present at an angle of 90 degrees. You can see here, proximal centriole and distal centriole. Now the question arises that what is the role of the proximal centriole? So always remember this proximal centriole. PC means proximal centriole, DC means distal centriole. Okay. So this proximal centriole, at the time of fertilization, is given to egg. Okay, at the time of fertilization, this proximal centriole by the sperm is given to the egg, and this proximal centriole, this proximal centriole helps in first cleavage division. It helps in first cleavage division of zygote, and zygote is also called as beta. It is also called as fertilized egg. Are you getting what I want to say? That proximal centriole at the time of the fertilization is given to the egg, and this proximal centriole helps in first cleavage division of the zygote. Okay, and now coming to the next one, and that is known as the distal centriole. What is the role of the distal centriole? So remember this thing, that distal centriole forms the axial filament, forms the axial filament, this one forms the axial filament found in middle piece, found in middle piece, which extends up to tail of sperm. Are you getting? It forms the axial filament found in the middle piece, which extends up to the tail region. So you can see here that this distal centriole has formed the axial filament, which is not only found in the middle piece, but it is also extended up to the tail region. Okay, and one thing more, that the axial filament is a fibrillar structure means it consists of 9 plus 2 arrangement of fibrils. Means if I see the transverse section of the axial filament, two fibrils are centrally located, while 9 fibrils found in doublet fashion are present at periphery. This 9 plus 2 arrangement is just like that what we have seen in the internal structure of the flagella. In the infrastructure of the flagella also we see the 9 plus 2 arrangement. So remember this thing, the axial filament which is formed by the distal centriole, which is found in the middle piece as well as the tail, is a fibrillar structure. Means it consists of several fibers. I want to say it consists of several fibers, and the arrangement of the fibrils is 9 plus 2, means 2 fibrils are centrally located, while the 9 fibrils are found in the doublet fashion and are present at the periphery. Okay, so this is about the axial filament and all about the proximal and the distal centriole. Now coming to the third important part of the sperm structure, and that is beta, known as the middle piece. So now we'll be discussing the middle piece, third part of the sperm, very important part, middle piece. Now this middle piece consists of axial filament. You have seen just now axial filament formed by distal centriole. Okay, not only this, the middle part consists of 25 to 30 mitochondrias. 25 to 30 mitochondrias. Middle part consists of 25 to 30 mitochondria, and these are present in form of a spiral sheet. These are present in form of a spiral sheet called, this might be new for you people, Nebelkern sheet. Okay, just I want to say that the mitochondria, which are found in the middle part or the middle piece of the sperm, are present in the form of a spiral sheet like this. This is a spiral sheet like this, and this spiral sheet of mitochondria is called as the Nebelkern sheet. Okay, and remember this thing, that mitochondria are powerhouse of sperm, as they provide energy to sperm for movement, or I can say swimming, right? So mitochondria are the powerhouse of the sperm, because as we know very well that the sperm is motile in humans, and it is having the motility power. It can swim just because of the mitochondria provides energy to it. Okay, now one thing I want to say here, that remember this thing, this is new for you people, that half head means this one, half head neck, and this is new for you people, and complete middle piece, half head, the neck, and the complete middle piece is surrounded by manchet layer, right? So if this terminology comes somewhere, then it is associated with the sperm. Remember this thing, half head, the complete neck, and the complete middle part or the piece is surrounded by a layer, and that layer is known as the manchet layer. Okay, now next one, you can see that, remember this thing, that at junction of middle piece and tail, a ring centriole, here it is, ring centriole is found, which is also called annulus, through which axial filament enters tail, but its function is unknown. We know that the functions of the proximal centriole and distal centriole are well defined, but the ring centriole, also called as the annulus, which is found at the junction of the middle piece and the tail, its function is unknown, and this is the place through which the axial filament of the middle piece enters into the tail region. So you must know about this also. Clear? Now, the axial filament is extended up to the tail region. Fine. Now, coming to the next one, and that is the fourth part of the human sperm, and that fourth part is called as the tail. Okay, so the fourth part is the sperm tail, also called as the flagella, because of tail human sperm is motile. Because of tail, human sperm is motile. Okay, and axial filament is also found in tail. But it's not necessary that all the organisms are having the motile sperm. Okay, one thing here is that the sperm of Ascaris is immotile. This is an extra point for you people, that the sperm of Ascaris is motile and immotile. The sperm of Ascaris is immotile, does not have tail, right? The sperm of Ascaris is immotile and it shows amoeboid movement. It shows amoeboid, amoeba-like movement, amoeboid movement. It shows the amoeboid movement. Fine. So these are the four parts of the sperm: head, neck, middle piece, and the tail. And here I can write it that it is the manchet layer. As I have said you, the manchet layer was around the half part of the head, the neck, and the entire middle piece. Okay, so this is the structure of the human sperm. Now let's talk something extra, that for fertility, remember this thing, that we know very well that in single ejaculation, in single ejaculation or during coitus or copulation, male release 200 to 300 million sperms in 1.5 to 3 ml of semen. So remember this thing, for fertility 60% of sperms must have normal shape and size. 60% of the sperms must have normal shape and size, and rest 40% of sperms must show vigorous motility. Is it clear what I want to say? In single ejaculation or during the process of the coitus, male releases 200 to 300 million sperms in 1.5 to 3 ml of the semen. But for the fertility, out of this, 60% of the sperm must have normal shape and size, and rest 40% of the sperm must show vigorous motility. Also, you must know that what is semen. Although we have discussed this part in the male reproductive section, okay, when I was explaining the male reproductive system, I have already explained, but still, semen consists of seminal plasma plus sperms, and you know very well seminal plasma is released by prostate, okay, and the another glands known as the bulbourethral glands, plus the major part of the seminal vesicle is released by the seminal vesicle. Okay, so the secretions of the seminal vesicle and the bulbourethral glands and the prostate glands all combine to form the seminal plasma. So the seminal plasma plus the sperm is equal to what? The semen. So you must have information about the semen also. So today we have discussed the structure of the human sperm, in which we have seen in detail that what is the head, the second part was known as the neck, the third part was known as the middle piece, and the fourth part was known as the tail region. Okay, so thanks a lot for watching me.